You are listening to The Voice of the Gospel, a proclamation of the Holy Gospel by Wisdom Ministries.
January 3rd, Sunday, the solemnity of the Epiphany of the Lord. Let's begin this day with the blessings of our Lord Jesus Christ. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who was being born King of the Jews? For we observed his star as it is rising, and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage.' When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them, when the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Happy Feast Day, my dear friends. We don't have much historical information about these wise men and their journey. So Matthew says they came from east. Some have speculated they were from Persia. We like to think that there were three of them, but St. Matthew does not say that, and the number has varied throughout the church history. We call them Caspar, Melchior, and Balthasar, but those names did not come about until the 7th century. But what about the star? It has been viewed as a supernatural phenomenon, just as a regular star, a comet, or sometimes as a conjunction or a grouping of planets. This anonymity and lack of historical information is a reminder that this story, this epiphany journey, is not just the wise man's journey. It is everyone's journey. The truth of sacred scripture is never limited to or contained and lonely to the past. In the past, we do not know what was in the sky, what they saw the first night. We do not know what was in their minds, what they thought, asked, or talked about. I do not know what was in their hearts, what they felt, dreamed, or longed for. But I know that there have been times when we each have experienced epiphany. Times when our night sky has been lit brightly. Times when our minds have been illumined. Times then our hearts have been enlightened. Those times have revealed to us a life and world larger than before. There have been moments that gave us the courage to travel beyond the borders and boundaries that usually circumscribe our lives. Epiphanies are those times when something calls us, moves us to a new place, and we see the face of God in a new way. So human that it almost seems ordinary, maybe too ordinary to believe. That's what happened to the wise men. They began to see and hear the stories of their lives. Something stirred within them, and they began to wonder, to imagine that their lives were part of a much larger story. Could it be that the one who created life, who hung the stars in the sky, noticed them, knew them, lived with them, and was calling them? Could it be that the light they saw in the sky was a reflection of the divine light that burned within them, that burns within each one of us? To seriously consider these questions is to begin the journey. That journey took the wise men to the house where they found the answer to their questions in the arms of his mother, Mary. The journey took the wise men to the house where they found the answer to their questions in the arms of their mother, Mary. We may travel a different route than the wise men did, but the answer is the same. Yes, God notices us, knows us, lives within us, and calls us. God is continually revealing himself in and through humanity in the flesh. Yes, these are the stories of our lives, epiphanies that forever change who we are, how we live, and the road we travel. There are moments of ordinary everyday life in which divinity is revealed in humanity and we see God's glory face to face. Amen. May God bless us. Happy Feast Day.